Ultimately, starting around 1600, people just stopped taking them seriously. Shakespeare was writing things like A Midsummer Night's Dream, and from that point on, we see the elves diminishing down into little fairies dancing among the flowers. This more or less reached its peak with works like Peter Pan from very early 20th century literature.
Is it Tinkerbell? Little flimsy creature with wings. Well, this was the Victorian and Edwardian age in which Tolkien grew up. There was a whole school of fairy painting, which was immensely popular right up to the First World War. But Tolkien, as he read his way more and more onto ancient literature, he thought that the whole idea of elves and the fairies had been diminished and downgraded. And I think that really bugged Tolkien. And he wanted to go back to what he saw as a nobler conception.
Tolkien's elves were an amalgamation of all of the reading and research that Tolkien had done and all of his knowledge and love for ancient myth and legend.
He's a kind of mythic Sherlock Holmes who can put the clues together in a way that nobody else ever has. For instance, there's the Old Norse fragments about what kind of elves there are. It says there are Ljósálfar, light elves, and Dúkálfar, which are dark elves. Well, this caused immense confusion to many scholars.
Can I go on your room? Can I wear your clothes?
No.
Solution
can you wear them right now?
Just come back.
Can I try
right,
on your makeup?
Sophie, I love you, but no. Bye, Dad. I'm heading out to Mimi's birthday. I'll be back tonight.
Jaden's leaving to have fun without me. Sophie, think of something quick. I feel sick.
And in this case, the light is the light invaluable. The undying last.
Mom's right,
because
you gotta
like come.
Now I gotta
to
take
Valinor,
care of you whatever you want. You order me around for every little thing.
But
and you never say thank you.
Miracle.
What's the hold
they
up?
Stay in
that
what was then green would be great. And those are the
when I bring you water, you say you want ice. Say you need some pillows so
the way
you can rest. But when I come
is,
back, you jump in on the bed.
Cut
you
in
a
leg.
Now you
wanna
cry. Get it what you want with the bed of an eye.
When
I got up asleep, wanna take a sick day, well, good try. Cut you in a line, now you wanna cry. Get in what you want at the bed of an eye. Wait until you see what I got up asleep. Wanna take a sick day, well, good try.
Gotta
wonder what gets
on me,
honestly. How do you get away with all of this constantly? The way you got my around your fingers like cogs. I gotta catch you in the act, so she'll finally see how to give you a taste of your own medicine. Oh, just wait.
Say what you like about our ill-tempered kid.
Gonna have some fun, you'll see how it is.
Cut
you in a line, now you wanna cry. Get it what you want with the bed of an eye. Wait until you see what I got up asleep. Wanna take a sick day? Well, good try. Cut you in a line, now you wanna cry. Get it what you want at the bed of an eye. Wait until you see what I got up asleep. Wanna take a sick day? Well, good try.
You can't
but that
go.
Doesn't work for a film, of course.
Fine,
it never
see,
will.
Like,
you have to bring character because
jump.
How does an
yeah,
audience
it's fine.
Hear
so
about
can just come
them?
With
and
absolutely
that was the pivotal role that
she's been sick all day,
played.
And now I'm not even sure she was telling the truth.
Well, you
see
what happened.
It was my fault.
Listen,
Sophie kept asking me this way earlier, and I kept telling her no. Sophie,
because
if you promise to be truthful, maybe Dad will give you another chance to come to the party with me.
Of course, Bill.
I'm
sorry. Yes. Kid really wants to take you.
No more lying, okay?
Okay,
but why did you?
No, that's a
basic
story.
Oh, what?
These stories really reflect female characters, particularly The Hobbit.
We're not going to get out there.
Hey, check it out! I just learned to play a bunch of new pop songs on Simply Guitar.
Because of the testosterone,
you
were stuck with
these dumb apps when we all know that. What? Damn, this song?
Creating a good, strong female character that could help her own story, and we looked at a few interesting places where that could happen. Could she be a hobbit?
We thought about the idea of female characters. We thought about somebody in Lake Town. I mean, we did consider different ideas way, way back at the beginning.
I am. I'll make something, and you'll make something, and then we'll see who's the favorite.
We didn't just want to create the cycle of creating a female character. She needed to have purpose in this garden. Kim was framing the suit.
Yeah. Just as an interesting idea, because then we thought we could explore the idea of an elven female character who is not Galadriel, she's not the wise, she's taking directions that would be kind of fun as the majors.
Originally, I'm in the course of May, how was she sitting to go to his ego all out in the session. And one of the things he wrote down was about my friends and me. He said, yeah, that my generation ain't a Y and Z. And he said, let me hear it. And she said, that's it. That's a man.
Really?
Get over here, William.
People say that my female character has been talking stories, but of course, you have the lady Galadriel, who is the most powerful of them all in many ways. As he's never felt female characters fighting before, the lady Eowyn, in Lord of the Rings, she was a warrior himself. I am
sexist in the way that, you know, the elves, the warriors, all the blokes, and the women say, I'm a crook. I mean, it's not like that. But at the same time, we did want Tariel just to be a warrior princess. You know, she had to have more accessory, more interest.
Over the months, Tariel's character evolved, and we did a lot of design work that involved the lead male. Very fortunately, really I sit as a judge on this amazing event in New Zealand that happens every year called the World Wearable Arts. And it was on stage I saw this dragon-like woven out of leaf mail and fine chainmail costume that was so beautiful and so inspiring. Created by a New Zealand artist called Eve Gilliland. So I approached her and asked her if she'd consider coming to the workshop and sharing it with us.